Okay, let's talk about one which seems to be getting it all right, Manappuram Finance. And the stock is a telltale sign. It's shot up 160% in the last 1 year. They've also now diversified into the non-gold business segment. So let's chat with Mr. VP Nandkumar, the MD and CEO at Manappuram Finance. He joins us in the show right now. Mr. Nandkumar, hi, morning. Firstly, your stock has been on a fire of late, a significant traction in the stock price. Tell us a little bit more about how you've managed to successfully diversify the business offerings to CVs, MFIs, etc. And what really is the business plan going forward for these segments?
Yeah, as you know, we have been a premier player in the gold loan segment for the last one decade, and we have been maintaining that and growing that. Last year also, we have grown our gold loan book. Due to demonetization, there was some impact on the disbursals as such, because historically this is a conventionally this is a cash business, full cash business. Now we are slowly moving to a cashless mode also through our online gold loan, digital gold loan product. Because of demonetization, the currencies were not available at the branches, which impacted the dispersals. It has gone down to 40%. Now it has come back to around 95%. I hope by next month the gold loan dispersal will reach the 100%, which was of the same level of pre-demonetization era. So gold loan is growing, and it has a potential for growth also, but at the same time we don't want to concentrate on a single product, because single product as the regulators see it, as we also see it, single product has its own risks. So we thought of diversifying. We identified certain areas. One area is microfinance. We acquired more than 90% of Asirvad Microfinance, which is a Chennai-based company. And after our acquisition, these companies also speedily distributed across the country and grown. And that company is doing well. Post demonetization, there are some impact in some collections in some places in the microfinance industry, but luckily in most of these places our presence is meager. But for Karnataka we have some presence in Bangalore, but our recovery is improving, steadily improving. The overall recovery rate has crossed 92%, and month on month the collections are improving. There will be some at the same time, I hope there will be some impact on the NPA level in places like Bangalore, which will fully write off during this plans to write off during the this quarter, last quarter. So the other businesses which we are in is home finance, which is doing well. We have built a portfolio of 300 crores and it is steadily growing. The other portfolio is the commercial vehicle segment. Luckily on these areas there is no much impact of demonetization. Anyway, all with demonetization, everything, we are hopeful that we will maintain our profitability plans, growth plans this year also.
How much of your current business you would classify is coming from the non-gold segment now?
The total is around 15% is coming from non-gold segment now.
Do you think that the mix is going to change dramatically?
We want to do that. By 2025 at least we plan to have 50-50 from gold loan and 50 from non-gold segment. So we want to aggressively grow this home loan portfolio. This is our primary thrust is affordable housing finance, which we are expanding The other which we want to grow is the commercial vehicle finance area. We are planning that to do the business in the south as well as west to begin with. Thereafter, we will expand to other areas. But microfinance also we are distributing across the country. To what risk is the political risk and other risks. Sometimes what happens in some areas because of drought or other natural calamities, the collection can be impacted. We plan to mitigate that risk also.
Right. Mr. Nankumar, I'm just going to interrupt you over there. There were recent media reports stating that promoters are looking to sell some stake in Manappuram. Is there any truth to that?
I have denied that completely. It's a false news. It's a false rumor. There is no basis.
So now, in order to grow your non-gold book, you will have to make a lot of changes, both in terms of distribution and your cost of capital. Now, the non...
Absolutely.
How are you prepared for that? I mean, with the existing book, the existing cash level, can you do this kind of a migration, or you'll have to dilute a lot?
No, we can do that because we are better capitalized. Our tier 1 capital itself is over 20%, whereas the statutory requirement is 12%. So we are very well above that. That capital can be used for other businesses also. Gold loan, the prospects of a growth of around 20% can be maintained even after allocating the capital for other businesses, which will protect our ROE always at a level of about 20%. What I am targeting is an ROE of 20%. So there is no need of any dilution. We have adequate capital to ensure a robust growth in areas like home finance, SME finance, then again vehicle finance and microfinance.
Okay. All right, sir. Appreciate your time. Thank you for joining us. Let's take a break. The first one after market opening. When we come back, we'll connect with Saurabh Mukherjee of Ambit Capital.